a proper establishment of this thing will be the ultimate solution for all the predicaments in various levels of the society. You have taken this topic as leadership. It is very clearly meant that there will be a person who is going to lead others. And it is quite common and it is very simple. But being very simple in its terminology and in structure, in practical visibility and experience, the qualities that are required to get an effective leadership, giving perennial source of harmony, peace and prosperity divided in the society, that has become a daydream and myth, by which even it is known, even it is chattered between people, and even it is very much common in colloquial usage and debates, we are in a position to ponder upon these things with more cogitation, so that we can bring the real essence of the meaning for which it has been destined to. Leadership means one has to lead the others, but to lead others, he must have knowledge without which he cannot lead. And apart from knowledge of things, he should have the magnanimity to lead others. At the time, he must be unalloyed in his status. And this should be very perpetual, cyclic. There should not produce any temporal gap or intermittence in the society. So considering these various difficulties in the practical experience of the benefits and fruits of the term as well as the attribute of leadership, we have started something to do with the presentations given by various people as per their exposure, erudition and experiences. And now to start with, leadership is nothing but the product of a spirit. Spirit is of two types. You know that soul is also called as a spirit. The energetic emanation of the consciousness of a person is also a spirit. He is a spirited person. And eschatology spirit means a departed spirit. Bhuta, Preta, innumerable versions are there. But spirit here contextually refers to an energetic emanation of the functional consciousness of a person. So, spirit is defined as the efficiency with which a person can perceive, conceive, analyze, plan, design, move and mobilize. Mobilize a set of effective and definite series of actions. So, this is what we call leadership. Leadership is defined as the efficiency with which a person can perceive, conceive, analyze, plan, design, move by himself and also mobilize others. This type of definition has been given for spirit. And you know that this spirit is not available on people in equal proportions. There is somnolent people, there are vehement people, there are stagnant people, there are inert people, and there are insufficient people, and there are aberrant personalities. So, as the society faces disparity in the status and gravity of the so-called demanded spirit, that requires a commanding force, unifying force, eye-opener force to integrate everything for a common productive cause. That particular force is known as leadership. As the society is full of somnolent, ineffective, insufficient, aberrant, inert, and non-dynamic or misdirected forces, that required a super force to take care of everything, to tackle everything, to put everything in the proper orbit and axis. That is known as leadership. And leadership that emanates from inherence, as well as it also takes care of urge. Inherence is the cradle of a person's awakened consciousness. That is inherent. But contextually or circumstantially, that comes as an urge when a person is either exposed to the society or when the society calls a person due to circumstantial demand and command. So, leadership comes out of inherence. It comes out of urge, and that urge is especially from a person's exposure to the circumstances or a strong demand from the circumstances. The structure of leadership is being diligent, confident and vibrant. Diligent is ever energetic. Confident is, it is above faith. It is above false hope. It is above speculation and imagination. A person who intellectually governs things and has a strong confidence which is coupled with dynamism, that coupled with dynamism, that effect is known as real confidence, and that is practical and infallible. So such a person who is dynamic, having a confidential hope as well as an effective implementation methodology, and also he should be vibrant. He should be vibrant. That means he should be able to instill, inculcate, radiate and implant the same diligence and confidence in others. by his speech, by his touch, by his motion, by his practical way of open book source of life. So by his life, speech, action and association, any person who is having the diligence as well as the confidence which is translatable, transmittable to other people, which is having a salubrious, contagious nature, that nature is known as vibrant. So this is what we call leadership. And what is the purpose of leadership? Why we have to possess leadership? Without leadership, there will be three phases of abnormality. There are a lot of resources in the society in various forms, and there needs to be an integrity in the society, and society has different types of people with different levels of performance skills. So there is a social potential output. If there is no leadership, then there will be disproportionate share of resources between the people. If there is no proper leadership, then organizational integrity among the society will be challenged and the social potential output will be disturbed and diluted if there is no proper direction of leadership. So in order to integrate the society and its organization, in order to properly channelize the potential output of the society, as well as for the proportionate distribution of the resources of the society, it requires a honest, salubrious, multi-purposeful, dynamic, multi-dimensional leadership. Now the social output or the social system is not like that. We have different types of leaderships now. Number one, there is no leadership at all. Whatever we call as leadership, see as leadership, somebody proclaiming them as leaders or being very much designated as leader, that is not leadership. So we have no leadership in various areas, Rajakar. And number two is we have number of leaders claiming that they are working for the same cause but disturbing others and also being disturbed in their unanimity within themselves. The third thing is we are having an inefficient puppet administrator or a puppet show administrator, or we are having an enable or a person who is totally imbecile to have the qualities of leadership to be implemented for a social benefit. And fourth thing is we are having a malevolent person. The first thing is no proper leadership. Second is lot of leaders. The third thing is inefficient leader. Fourth is a malevolent leader. He is a potential person, but he is malevolent in nature. He may be either self-centric, he may be tyrant, or even go to the level of being antisocial. That is what we are seeing now. And also in leaderships, there is self-leadership.